So we've all seen Addison's mom dancing on TikTok. Anybody with those moves for sure knows how to whip up some fire food. I think it would be so cool if you entered this side of food TikTok. I know you got it in you, and it would be awesome if you remade one of our recipes or showed us one of your original fixings. So my challenge for you, Mrs. Ray, is to show us how you throw it down, and if you need any help, we got you. It would just be really cool if you did this. I appreciate you. The last time I made healthy chicken nuggets, hundreds of you remade them. And yeah, we decided that boneless wings are not a thing, but nonetheless, these were delicious. And remember, these are a healthier alternative. You want to start off by cubing up your chicken tenders and hitting them with some salt and Cajun. Cover them up with a little olive oil and go in with some breadcrumbs, or you can grind up some almonds. Now you want to cook them in the air fryer, or you could oven bake them. In the hot pan, you want to go in with some oil, garlic, ginger, soy sauce or coconut amino acid, a tiny bit of hoisin and vinegar, sesame seed oil, and a pinch of crushed red pepper flakes. Midway through, you want to flip the nuggets, then toss them into that delicious sauce. Give them a nice little flip with the sauce, toss them in a plate, sprinkle on some sesame seeds, a couple green onions, and now we have final product. And now, bismillah. A healthier Nashville hot chicken sandwich. That's kind of the vision that I wanted to take this recipe at first, but honestly, it just turned out as a really clean chicken sandwich. You want to start off by salt and cayenne peppering both sides of a chicken breast, then slab it up with your favorite vinegar-based hot sauce. And instead of breadcrumbs or flour, we're actually gonna grind up some almonds. Now you might think this is crazy, but it's honestly incredibly good. This sort of reminded me of the cashew chicken at Cheesecake Factory. We're using the hot sauce as a wet batter and we're coating everything up with the almonds. You wanna make sure that your chicken is proportionate in size, just so it cooks evenly. Midway in the baking process, you wanna pull out the chicken and slab on a little bit more of that hot sauce. I air fried this for about 10 to 15 minutes, or you could easily bake it or pan fry it. Go in with a little bit of low fat mayo, and you could always use a lettuce wrap if you're trying to save on calories. Slice that bad boy up, and then we have final product. And now, bismillah. I'm coming at you today with a delicious salmon bowl. This dish is extremely healthy and nutritious, and at the same time, it's extremely tasty. You wanna start off by prepping whatever vegetables that you prefer. You could also add some fruit like I did with some mango. Cube up and season your salmon. And a couple years ago, I spent the summer in Dubai working in a kitchen. They made this really easy and quick salmon. You wanna toss in the salmon in an extremely hot pan. Give them a flip after like 30 seconds on each side. Go in with soy sauce or teriyaki. And now you got some beautiful salmon. And again, here's me sliding in with the new merch. It's dropping tonight, and I want to thank every single one of you for the constant support. I'll be announcing the winner soon from yesterday's video. And now on top of a better rice, you want to plate up your salmon. Go in with all the favorite toppings, a little sesame seeds, and now we have final product. And as usual, now bismillah. In my opinion, omelets are crazy underrated. Here's how to take your omelets to the next level. You want to start off by chopping up your favorite vegetables. I got a red bell pepper, white onion, jalapeno, and some carrots. And instead of adding butter or oil, I'm going to render down some beef bacon. The beef bacon gets nice and crispy and adds a delicious smokiness to the whole dish. Cook down your vegetables, season up your eggs. You want to whisk them thoroughly and then add it to the omelet. Now when you toss on your eggs, you want to cover it and lower the heat to a medium low. 10 to 15 minutes and you got this beautiful texture. And if you don't drop a follow, I'm gonna let it slide. Get it, omelet? Now top it off and we have final product. Now, bismillah. We're continuing our journey to travel around the world in our kitchen, and today we're landing in Jamaica. We're making Jamaican jerk chicken. You wanna start off by cross-hatching your drumstick and your chicken leg piece. This is so that beautiful marinade can penetrate the meat. Now for this dish, the magic happens in the marinade. Green onion, white onion, scotch bonnet peppers because Jamaicans don't play. Lime, garlic, ginger, a splash of vinegar and soy sauce. And now you want to go in with a bunch of spices that are listed out on the screen. And now when everything is combined, you want to blend that bad boy up. And if I've provided you with value in any way so, I dropped some merch that's linked in the bio if you'd like to support. Now you want to mix everything up until it gets nice and lovey-dovey and marinate overnight. Now you can oven bake these or toss them on the grill. The marinade is insanely delicious. Touch them with some lime and now we have final product. And now bismillah. I was 3 years old when I found out my cousin has never tried Panda Express's honey walnut shrimp. This is ludicrous. So you know I had to put them on. You want to start off with 4 egg whites and a bunch of cornstarch. Give them a heavy beating until they start to swell up. Now you want to toss in your peeled and deveined shrimp and take them to the fryer. And then you just want to toss in the walnuts with some water and brown sugar on some medium-high heat. Flash fry the shrimp, and to be honest, you'll be surprised on how easy the sauce is to make. And just some condensed milk, some mayo, and a little bit of honey. Now you want to toss in everything together, and remember, you got to take care of the fam. You got to put them on some delicious food. Hit them with a couple sesame seeds, and then we have final product.
And now, bismillah.
I'm trying to lose weight. I gotta eat some salad. Nah, I'm gonna show you how to make some chicken wings, but make them a little bit cleaner. You wanna pat down the chicken wings so they're nice and dry on the surface. And to make them extra crispy, we're gonna go with some baking powder. That's the secret. I just tossed on some salt and Cajun for these. And every time I make a high energy voiceover, everyone's asking me why I'm yelling. And when I'm nice and calm, everyone's asking why I'm sad and depressed. One time someone told me that my voiceover sound like I'm held on gunpoint. Y'all just confusing me at this point. For the wings, you could go with any low calorie sauce, or you can eat them plain. And now I'm about to slide in your screen with some new merch. Comment down below when and why you followed me. And I'm gonna choose one person to get a free t-shirt. The merch dropping tomorrow, baby. And these wings are nice and low calorie because they're not deep fried and battered. And as always, now bismillah. This is by far my favorite pasta dish of all time. It's simple, quick, and hits different. You want to start off by turning your water into the ocean. Don't forget, this is the only opportunity to actually season your pasta, and I'm using linguine here. And always make sure that you save some of your pasta water. I hit some scallops with some salt and Cajun, tossed them for like 90 seconds on each side, and then took them out the pan. If you overcook your scallops, they might turn into rubber. But we want some nice crustification, but keeping them tender on the inside. And for the nice pasta sauce, you want to start off by melting some butter, cooking through a little bit of garlic, and going in with the juice of a lemon. Give everything a nice little swirl on a medium-high heat, then toss in your pasta water. The pasta water is starchy, which thickens up the sauce. Then you want to finish off with some lemon zest and chives. Toss in your linguine noodles, let them dance with the pasta sauce, give it a nice little swirl, and start plating that bad boy up. And if you're enjoying these food videos, I'd love you forever if you dropped a follow. Toss on your scallops, finish off with some fresh chives, and we have final product. This pasta honestly hits different. And now, bismillah. When I was going about my weight loss journey, I was obsessed with these chicken nuggets. And just for the record, boneless wings are not chicken wings. But you can consider these a healthier chicken nugget slash boneless wing. You want to cube up a bunch of chicken breasts and season it with a bunch of seasonings. The seasonings will be on my Instagram, don't worry, I got you there. And instead of battering them up and frying them, I'm going to hit them with a little bit of olive oil and toss them in with a bunch of breadcrumbs. These are like the healthier version that have a lot less calories. I'm going to toss them in the air fryer. You could go in into a really hot oven as well. And here's me reminding you, if you don't use it, you lose it. So get up and move, baby, I got you. Make sure you flip the wings halfway through so they get nice and crispy. And you can eat these without a sauce because they already have a lot of flavor. But this is a lower calorie sauce. I'm going to start on 1 tablespoon of butter. It's not that many calories. Lemon zest, garlic powder, a bunch of parsley or cilantro, whatever your preference is. I'm going to toss in the crispy wings with the sauce. Give them a nice little flip together. They're nice and crispy. And now we have final product. Now, bismillah. Many of us can't travel due to COVID-19. So today we're going to travel in our kitchen to Argentina. Let's make some Argentinian empanadas. You want to start off by prepping your filling with some onions, peppers, jalapenos, green onions, a couple green olives, and in my opinion, what takes it to the next level, some hard-boiled eggs. The goal of this series is to make an authentic dish around the world on a weekly basis. That way we can travel without actually traveling. You want to start to saute your onions, bell peppers, and jalapenos. Season them up with cumin, paprika, salt, and in my opinion, a little bit of allspice, which takes it to the next level. Then you want to toss in your ground beef and season it the same way we did the vegetables. Once the filling is cooked, you want to toss in your hard-boiled eggs, your olives, and your green onions. And for your dough, you can make a puff pastry or a pie crust, works very well. You want to toss on a little egg wash on the outside, start stuffing your dough. You can deep fry, oven bake them, or you can even air fry them. 400 degrees at 8 minutes. And as always, now bismillah. When I was going about my weight loss journey, I used to make this coconut curry pizza. No joke, this pizza is delicious, nutritious, and filling. You want to start off by seasoning some chicken tenders with some salt and curry powder. Then you want to toss in the chicken into some dancing oil in a really hot pan. You want to cook the chicken about 70% of the way, just because we want it to cook with the curry sauce and not overcook. Then you want to go in with some onions, jalapenos, and carrots and season them the same way we did with the chicken. You can use whatever veggies you prefer. Then I tossed in a hefty amount of curry paste, and to save on like 1/3 of the calories, I went in with some light coconut milk. You also want to season that coconut milk, bring it to a boil, and then let it simmer for about 20 minutes. You want it to get nice and thick. Re-add the chicken and toss them on whatever vessel of bread that you prefer. I was using a whole wheat naan. This recipe is not in any way authentic, but it definitely hits different. You want to toast them in the oven till they get nice and bubbly. Fresh cilantro, and we have final product. Now, bismillah. So you know the Arby's beef and cheddar sandwich? That boy definitely hits different, so here's my variation of it. Instead of using, you know, a regular roast beef, I'm using some ribeye. You want to douse it in some Worcestershire sauce, garlic powder, paprika, salt, and some oregano, and then you want to season the other side. You want to toss it on a baking tray and toss it into the oven at 300 degrees. I cooked it for about 40 minutes until it turned like 135 internal temperature. Then I let it rest for about 10 minutes, thinly sliced it. Like, try to sharpen your knife and go as thin as possible. I don't have an onion roll, so I toss it on a butter roll, nacho cheese, and now we have final product. Now, bismillah.
Let's make Taco Bell's grilled cheese burrito. Taco Bell just came out with a new grilled cheese burrito, so let's make one. You want to start off with your Spanish rice, your ground beef, nacho cheese, chipotle mayo, surprisingly their low-fat sour cream, and a bunch of flaming hot Fritos, but I only have the chili cheese. Now you want to roll it up. And now in a hot pan, add your cheese and toss on your burrito. As the cheese crisps up, you want to turn your burrito inside of it. You want to get that beautiful cheese nice and seared in. Now you want to slice it in half. And now we have final product. And now bismillah.
This smoothie is not made for children. It can replace a meal if you'd like. Or if you just hit a beastly workout, you could drink it. You want to go in with some pineapples, mangoes, blueberries, blackberries, a couple strawberries. And then here's when it starts to fill you up. A bunch of oats, some protein, some peanut butter. And if you'd like to make it a little bit sweeter, a bunch of honey. If your fruits are not frozen, you could always add ice. And then I like to finish with a bunch of almond milk. Blend that bad boy up, pour it up in a cup, and now we have final product. Now, bismillah.
Here's how to make the best hummus in the world. A lot of you have been asking me how to make hummus, so I'm gonna show you how. So you want chickpeas that are soaked overnight and boiled until fork tender, a bunch of lemon juice, a bunch of salt, a bunch of sesame paste, and surprisingly the secret ingredient, some ice cubes. Toss your hummus inside the food processor. Now you wanna drizzle in your sesame seed paste, go in with your lemon juice, and now you wanna go in with a bunch of salt. And now you wanna pulse it until it's a beautiful puree. Now if you find the puree to be a little bit too thick, toss in some ice cubes so it keeps the integrity of the puree and it's beautiful and silky. Now spread it out on a nice plate, give it a little bit of olive oil, and now we have final product. Now, bismillah.
If you're trying to add flavor to your life and make every single dish you make better, you have to try the secret that I always do. So you're trying to cook and trying to make all this food, right? I'm talking like all varieties, the secret works. You drop a like and a follow and instantly your life changes. Flavor is added to your life in all forms. So what are you waiting for? I know you want to be part of Food TikTok. The next time you make salmon, you need to try this recipe. And many of you have been asking for a really simple, easy recipe, so I got you. In a saucepan, you want to start on some onions and garlic, sweat them down, season the bad boys up with some salt and cajun, a little hoisin, teriyaki sauce, soy sauce, sesame seed oil. Mix them bad boys up and reduce them to a nice little thick sauce. Now on two fillets of salmon, get them cozy with the sauce, toss them in an air fryer or an oven, cook them for about 15 minutes, get them nice and toasty. And now we have final product. Now bismillah.
You already know when I make a sandwich, I make sure that boy mean. So today we're making a shish tabu sandwich. You want to cube up a bunch of chicken tenders, go in with a bunch of yogurt, a little ketchup or tomato paste, a squeeze of lemon juice, a little bit of olive oil, a very hefty pinch of salt. Now you better keep up because I'm about to go supersonic speed. Garlic powder, a little bit of cumin, a little bit of paprika, a little turmeric, a little cardamom, and a tiny bit of coriander seed. And don't you forget, details and measurements are on my Instagram, and I'd love you if you follow me there too. Or just right here. Now mix and marinate until you lose patience. Now to some dancing oil, toss in your marinated chicken. Medium high heat so the yogurt doesn't burn. And this is the bread of choice for today's sandwich. This boy talk different. Toss on your chicken, lay out a bunch of pickles, an unreasonable amount of spicy mayo, and a bunch of curly fries because I'm a psychopath.
And now before I roll it up, we have final product. Now bismillah. Alright, relax. A lot of you were asking for the recipe. So real quickly, this is just the chicken fried rice recipe. Season up some thin sliced chicken, toss in an onion, carrot, make sure everything is nice and small. And four fried rice, garlic goes a long way. Make a well in the middle, toss in some butter, whisk egg, season that bad boy up, mix everything together. I like to go with a hefty load of peas, a bunch of day old sushi rice so it absorbs all that flavor beautifully. Soy sauce, hoisin sauce, sesame oil, cilantro, and now we have final product. And now bismillah.
Here's how I make my favorite summer drink. Start off with a bunch of yellow watermelon. The yellow watermelon is gonna turn into the water or the liquid. Toss in two sun gold kiwis, a bunch of blueberries, and I got this beautiful hot honey. And now blend. Now pour it up. Toss in some tahini.
Now we have final product. Now bismillah.
When I was going about my weight loss journey, I made this kebab sandwich all the time. This sandwich is incredible. You want to start off by dicing an onion extremely fine, and then for the tomato, you want to gut it so the kebab still holds. I'm using a 93-7 ground beef recipe, which is very high in protein and low in fat. I also recommend that you finely chop everything a lot more than I did. And for the spices, we're going with some cumin, coriander seed, turmeric, paprika, salt, allspice, and ground cardamom. You want to combine everything in a mixing bowl and get it nice and lovey-dovey. Now you want to form everything into a nice beautiful log shape, and then you want to drizzle a little bit of olive oil on top of the kebab so they don't stick on the grill pan. And yes, you could air fry these, oven bake them, or grill them outside on the grill. And before you spaz out and tell me that pita bread is not healthy, you can always go with the lettuce wrap and make it keto, Bugs Bunny. And for the yogurt sauce, we're going with a little bit of low-fat yogurt, sesame paste, salt, and a little bit of lemon juice. Start piling up your sandwich, toss on fresh tomatoes, onions, a little bit of pickle.
And now we have final product. Now bismillah.
The perfect cheat meal smash burger. Let's go. You want to start off by taking 80-20 ground beef and balling them up into like 1/3 of a pound. Smash burgers are the easiest and quickest way to make a delicious burger without doing the most. And one of my favorite toppings is turkey bacon. You can cook them on the stovetop or just in the air fryer. In a screaming hot cast iron skillet, you want to start on a high smoke point oil and toss in your patty. And with the bottom of a plate, you want to smash it down until it starts yelling for help. And now you can just salt and pepper it or go in with whatever seasoning blend that you prefer. And the best thing about cooking good food is it doesn't need any beauty filters to actually look good. Nah, I'm just playing. All of you are beautiful. And honestly, the crustification is immaculate on this patty. Now I repeated that process for 3 of those patties. And now on a toasted bun, I added some mayo and ketchup. The 3 patties looking all gorgeous. Some of that crispy bacon. And because I'm a psychopath, I tossed some nacho cheese on some tater tots. Slice that bad boy in half. And now we have final product. Now bismillah.
So I had some leftover ground beef from yesterday's smash burgers, so I decided to make a nice little breakfast sandwich. In a hot skillet, I started on some turkey bacon, and yes, for those confused, turkey bacon is made out of turkey. Toss in my ground beef and season them bad boys up. Then I toss 2 eggs on top of the ground beef. And here's to remind you that if you have leftovers, you can make a small little sandwich that tastes absolutely delicious really quickly. Couple slices of plastic cheese, toss them on my brioche bun, and now we have final product. And now bismillah.
I wanted to explore food on a different level today. I feel like I needed to introduce something new to my palate. So I took myself to the farmer's market and bought a bunch of fresh ingredients. In a hot skillet, I toasted up my vegetables. I had some cauliflower, some yellow squash, serrano pepper, onion, shredded carrots, then seasoned them bad boys up and let them get nice and toasty and also cook through. Then I thin sliced some fingerling potatoes, tossed them in a cast iron skillet to get a very beautiful crust on them. This dish was honestly very refreshing and tasted really good, to be honest. And these jumbo shrimps were honestly insanely good. They're like mini lobster tails in my opinion. I also paired them with a bunch of fresh scallops. I tossed in a little bit of butter, chicken stock, and Worcestershire sauce, and made that into a puree. Then I seasoned up the shrimp and the scallop and went into the cast iron skillet to get a nice crust on both of them. For the puree, I added some turmeric and heavy cream, mixed that bad boy up, and honestly, my plating is probably a 4 out of 10, and this dish was honestly incredible. And now, final product. And now, bismillah. Yeah, you got that yummy, yum, that yummy, yum, that yum.